the only power.
You're
the only power. Rock the Yahweh.
All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I would like to give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushah, Bahashem Rakakadash, double honors unto the apostles and the elders of GMS, whom rule well, teach well, being great example towards younger brothers, and peace and blessing, salutations, hopeful lake out there pushing his word in truth and in sincerity across the four winds in the name of Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushah, pushing to get up out of here, Shalom to the hopeful lake, the believers, the listeners, whom have came back to the obedience of the scriptures through faith in Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushah. And what I want to get into this morning, you know, real quick, all right, just go into how, you know, we live in a society, you know, that's pretty much built up the economy. You know, when you go to the economy of this society, it's pretty much built up off the labor, okay, of Jake, the captivity of Jake. You know, even the world economy is pretty much, you know, bagged, is backed up, you know, off the labor, you know, of Jake. You know, and you have two forms of labor within this captivity, okay? You have our people that maintain this society, you know, people that work at these plants and, you know, the different professions as architects and engineers and, you know, doctors and different things or whatever you are, business owner, you know, dentist, whatever you are, all right, we're considered, you know, people that maintain this man's kingdom. And then you have what? Entertainers, okay? Either you're a maintainer or entertainer, all right? But at the end of the day, it's all, you know, based on our labor. You know, them niggas doing all them shows, that's labor. Them niggas is working. Studio, and them niggas is working. Okay, all these appearances, and, you know, it look cute, and like, the, you know, like, it's just the life, man. Them niggas is working, man. Okay? Now, when you read Psalms 14 and 4, all right, 144, you know, Abba Ratazah. It says, have all the workers of iniquity no knowledge, who eat up my people as they eat bread and call not upon the Lord, Yahweh, Bashem, Al-Shai. And this is beginning with Esau, Edom. You know, and these other nations as well, because as we know, Esau, Edom is the head, you know, of this great rebellion against Yahweh, Bashem, Al-Shai in the earth. You know, when it says they call not upon the Lord, Yahweh. Okay, and that's in obedience. Okay, and Esau pushes rebellion, you know, and then their process, there's a system set up where he's eating off our people, you know, because when you're getting, you know, how Jake said you get money in the hood, well, they say, you know, we eating, B, you know, we eating, you know. Well, Esau has been eating, has been feasting, you know, off the labor. Now you go into that word, eat in the Hebrew, as I call. And it says, to cause to eat, to feed with, to cause to devour. Okay? And it says to devour, to consume, to destroy. Okay? And you look at the mindsets of our people, it's a destroyed people, man. You know? The people that have not started the healing process through Yahushua, you know? Because if you're an Israelite and, you know, you haven't started that healing process through Yahushua, okay? You're destroyed. You might think you got it together, but the way you think is destroyed, you know, because we was in that destroyed, you know, state, and we pray not to go back to it. Now, I want to pull up a few things, okay? Now, let's just go to the, you know, just deal with the music industry, because when you look at the music industry, all right, and you look at the charts, and it says the annual analyst of recording music, total earnings, indicated that U.S. recorded music revenue grew by an impressive 13% from $9.8 billion in 2018 to $11.1 billion in 2019. Significantly, 2019 was the fourth consecutive year to feature double-digit revenue growth. Now, you have an industry, okay, that's grossing $11 billion a year, okay? So they don't mind giving you niggas tens of million dollars a year, okay? And they gross 11. You see? They don't mind paying you niggas, you know, this money. A lot of them niggas ain't getting money like that, man. You know? But Esau was eating off you niggas, man. Okay? He eating off all of us, man. Like I say, we that maintain this kingdom. Okay? Hey, these different industries, man. He's making a killing off the laborers, man. Okay? I think in the 80s, I heard the apostles bring it out in the 80s how for every dollar that the employee made, the CEO will make $25. But now, every dollar that the employee makes, the CEO makes $25,000, man. Okay? This is a very wicked kingdom, man. All right? And the main laborers are who? Jake. You see? So, let's go from here. Let's go. Which, I just want to deal with this graph. All right? No freaky E. Well, you look at the graph here. All right. Dealing with, okay, the NBA, 7.4 billion. Hollywood, 11.1 billion. Okay. NFL, 14 billion. Okay. So between the NBA, the NFL, all right, that's 21.4 billion plus 11.1, so that's $35.5 billion just off NBA, Hollywood, and NFL. Over $35 billion, man. Okay, that's why I don't mind giving you nigga these contracts, because they're eating off you, man. Okay, and you had Dame Dash speaking about trying to own the team. Jakes will never own the team. LeBron talking about some, yeah, after I get through, I want to be an owner. No, nigga. Okay, you could be a coach or an analyst, all right? Or you just going to sit your ass down, okay? Do some movies or something, all right? You going to work in one of his industries, man. Ain't no ownership, all right, for you Jakes, man, when it comes to true ownership, okay? So, the scriptures tell you that these people rejoiced at our condition. And see, us being separated from who we are separates us from a ruling class mentality, man. And that's what Esau wants to separate us from, man. And that's why, you know, Jake is okay with being a decorated slave in this society. You know, that gives them illusion as if they have some type of power. But no, they're just decorated slaves, man. Okay, now this is Revelation 11. And I started 9. It says, and they of the people and kindreds and tongues and nations shall see their dead bodies 3 days and a half, or 350 years, and shall not suffer their dead bodies to be put in graves. Yeah, because no one gave us the relief of knowing who we are and why we're in this position. You know, from the time that we came over here, you know, that the southern kingdom was brought over here with the northern kingdom to serve captivity, going back to 1619. Okay. Until the time of Elder Abel Bivens, which through Yahweh Shai was their comforter and pretty much, you know, gave us that relief of who we are and why we're in this position, man. Yahweh Shai promised he would send the comforter, and he did that, man. Okay? And it says, and shall not suffer their dead bodies to be put in graves. And they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry and shall send gifts one to another, because these two prophets tormented them that dwelt on the earth, man, going to the northern, you know, and southern kingdom, okay? And you know, it was a deeper breakdown, as the apostle always goes into dealing with Joshua and Zerubbabel, you know? Well, on the surface, you know, they're speaking of the northern and southern kingdom as well, and pretty much when you look at it, prophets, you know, is a part of our culture, having prophets, you know? Prophets is a part of our culture. And see, this society has destroyed our cultures as Israelites. That's why it says this in Jeremiah, you know, And they gave us a culture of entertainment and consumerism. Okay, because who stays in the worst, who lives in the worst, you know, who dwells in the worst living conditions on earth but have the most expensive cars, man? That's a destroyed mind frame. Okay? A destroyed mind frame, but that's because, hey, they destroyed our heritage and gave us one, man. Okay? Now, this is Jeremiah 50 and 11. It says, "And Chaldea shall be a spoil. All that spoil her shall be satisfied, said the Lord Yahweh by Shema Oshai. Because you were glad, because ye rejoiced." Going back to what? They, all right, made merry over us, man. "Oh," it says, "Oh, ye destroyers over mine heritage, because you are grown fat as the heifer grass," going to what? "They were eating, and bellow as bulls." Okay? And then you go right here. This is the NLT, Jeremiah 15:11. It says, "You rejoice and are glad, you who plundered my chosen people. You frisk about like a cow in a meadow, and they like a stallion." Esau been eating, man. Okay, off our captivity, man. This man has been eating. America became a superpower off the labor of Jake, man. Okay, Northern and Southern Kingdom, man. When they was taking them slaves from the west coast of Africa, man, they was taking essential Jakes, man, from these different societies over there in Western Africa. They wasn't just taking anyone, man. They was taking the architects and engineers and builders and, you know, thinkers and, you know, inventors. Okay? And Esau made a killing off that, man. He was eating. You see? But there's a destruction coming to this man. All right? And he's going to get paid back, man. And guess what? The Most High going to make it right through judgment. The Most High is coming for righteous judgment, man. This is Jeremiah 30:16. It says, "Therefore all they devour thee shall be devoured, and all thy adversaries, every one of them," all nations, beginning with Esau, Edom, okay? "And they that," it says, "shall go into captivity, and they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and all they that prey upon thee will I give for a prey." So we're, all right, going to do the same thing, okay? We're going to build grand cities, okay, off your labor, all right? We're going to, you know, our infrastructure is going to be built up off of your labor, okay? The resources are going to be, you know, you're going to harvest our resources, and we're going to reap all the benefits, okay? Hey, you finna get that same thing, man. So I just want to put that out there, man. You know, Esau been eating, but guess what? The scriptures say he finna vomit everything up, man. And his ass going to captivity, man. Shalom.